Okay, we'll just wait for Ms. Jaisal and Passion to move back to the meeting. Okay, Ms. Jaisal, let me know us let us know now if you're back already in the call. Check natin. Okay, let's just see kung nakapasok na ulit si Ms. Jaisal and Passion. Ms. Laverne, are you raising your hand? You have a question? Or baka napindot lang po? Miss Teach, wala pa. Wala pa akong ginagawa about Jamboard. Okay? Hindi ko pa siya sanang ginagamit eh. Kasi ako personally, hindi ko pa siya ma-recommend entirely din. Kasi may mga limitations pa si, ano, ano, si, si Jamboard. Alright, so teachers, I think makakapasok naman ulit si makakapasok naman agad din si Miss Jaisal. So hopefully makabalik na po rin si Miss Jaisal, okay? Miss Jaisal, let us know if you're back already, okay? Let's start na po with our session, okay? So una-una nating explore with Google Chrome would be the sign in. Okay? So paano nga ba mag-sign in, or yun nga importance ng sign in, no? It allows you to access your Google application seamlessly if you've signed in into your browser. Lalo na ang mga madami sa mga tools ni Google ay browser based, no? Okay? So dito sa taas, teachers, no, meron kang normally, okay, kung hindi ka pa naka-sign in, teachers, may nakalagay diyan na sign in. Okay? Dito sa upper right corner, but dahil naka-sign in ako sa Google account ko, lumalabas na din yung profile ko. Okay? You can actually click on that, teachers, and you will see all the profiles that are associated to this Chrome, no? Okay? So right now, for example, I could access my Kaagapay teaching support. So that's the Google account signed in into this Chrome. And of course, I could also access my other email, which is rankopiado.x.edu.ph. Okay? So you could actually add multiple accounts, no? So you could seamlessly transfer from one account to another. Okay, so that's how we sign in, and that's how and again, no, it's important. I highly recommend that you sign in whenever you're using your Chrome. Okay, and there's so many other more benefits na pag-uusapan din po natin later on. Okay, okay. So after maka-sign in, teachers, no, okay, you can now store data. Okay, so isang advantages ni Google Chrome kapag naka-sign in po kayo. Dahil kapag naka-sign in kayo, nakapag-store si Google sa inyong account or sa inyong Google account. Okay? So including na po dyan yung tinatawag nating bookmarks. No? So ano nga ba ang mga bookmarks, teachers? Okay? So basically, ang bookmarks, yan yung mga websites that you tag, that you created, no? For the easier the access ng mga websites na yun, okay? So ang ginagawa lang natin basically, katulad nga sa book, no, nagbo-bookmark tayo, okay? So nilalagyan natin ng mark or minamark natin yung particular webpage, okay, or website, okay? So that we could visit this website or webpage easily in the future, okay? So usually, recommended yung bookmarking for websites that you frequently visit or you usually visit. So for example, dito, teacher, sa taas, makita niyo po, no, sa taas ng aking tab, sa taas ng aking Chrome tab, dun sa baba ng aking search bar, okay, andun po yung tinatawag na bookmark tab. So dyan po nakalagay yung mga binookmark na websites or web pages, no, okay? So what's na advantage now? Okay, I don't need to type, for example, the website or the URL. I could simply click on that, for example, on this, I click on the bit.ly, okay? So since I usually use bit.ly for shortening different URLs, okay? So I needed to be bookmarked so I could easily access it. Okay, so now, how do we create a bookmark? Okay, so There are several ways, no? There are two ways, no? That one is shorter, one is long cut, okay? So the shortcut way of bookmarking a page, okay, is that using that star button at the end of the search bar, okay? So you will see there, pag tingin niyo po yung search bar ni teachers, no, makikita niyo po dun sa dulo, meron dong star, okay? When you're in a website and you click on that, it will bookmark that particular website, okay? So, for example, punta po tayo sa National Geographic Channel, Puntahan lang natin yung kanilang website. For example, you'd like to bookmark this particular website. Mag-open. Yeah, nag-open na siya. Okay? Ngayon, teachers, since nandun na ako ngayon sa website, no, and I'd like to bookmark this website, the only thing I need to do is to click on that star on top at the end of the search button. Okay? So when you click on that, it will ask you to name your bookmark. For example, this is the National Geographic channel. Okay. And then you can also assign where to put the bookmark. Okay, so meron kayong several options where to put your bookmark. So pwede kang other bookmarks, okay? Yung mapunta, or usually nga, nilalagay siya sa bookmark tab. Okay. So for example, let's just keep it in the bookmark tab. Okay. And then, let's just click on done. Okay. Now, what happens, teachers, no, kapag klinose ko tong tab na to, okay, and I open a new tab, okay, you can now see it, okay, on top, below the search bar, okay? So it now was included, no, in my bookmark tab, okay? So if I want, for example, to re-access it, I could just simply click it, okay? And then I can go back. No? So, napaka-importante to teachers, no, lalo na for sa mga students natin na nagre-research. Sometimes, kung saan-saan nila kinukuha yung information, nakakalimutan nila kung saan nila kinukuha yung information. So, it's important sometimes, it's important na kapag nagre-research tayo online, okay, we get to go back po, or revisit some websites, no? Either to confirm or to cite the website, etc. Okay, so, napaka-importante yung function ni bookmark yan. Pero sa akin personally, ang talagang function ni the bookmark ay for me to be able to easily access certain websites that I frequently visit. Okay? Ngayon, teachers, no, for example, what if madami ka mga inopen na tabs? Okay, can you actually put all of this can you bookmark all the tabs all together? Yes po, teachers, no? Pwede po natin gawin yan. Okay, so for example, hanap pa tayo ng ibang website. Hanap tayo na, for example, History Channel. Yan. Okay, so mga educational websites, no? Yan, for example, no? Yung tatlong yan. Okay, kunyari, nagre-research ka, no? So, ang dami mo ng tabs na inopen. At lahat yun mahalaga sa'yo. Okay? At gusto mong balikan lahat yun mamaya or later on for your research. No? So, the thing that you need to do is that let's use the other way na to bookmark certain pages. Okay? Doon sa taas, teachers, when you hover your mouse, no, doon sa taas, dapat may lalabas po doon na bookmarks. No? So, inyong menu. So, meron ka yung profile, edit, view, history, and then a tab called bookmarks. No? So, you can click on that. Okay? And then, meron kang option dito, teachers, no? Meron kang bookmark this tab. Ibig sabihin kung ano yung active na naka-open, yun po yung ibubookmark nyo, okay? But since what we want to do is to bookmark all of the open tabs, okay, at the moment, okay? Magbubookmark or all tabs po tayo, teachers, okay? So, balik tayo rin doon, bookmarks, okay? And then, bookmark all tabs, okay? And when that happens, teachers, no, it will ask Google Chrome will prompt you to create a bookmark folder. Okay, so ibig sabihin nandito lahat ng inyong mga web pages or websites that you bookmark all together. Okay, so parang ginugroup mo siya. So for example, this is our sample folder. So save lang natin yan, teachers. Okay. Now, close natin, for example, to. Okay. Yan. Okay, so when you open another tab, teachers, makikita mo na ngayon yung folder mo, ng tabs mo, nandun na po yun sa taas din, sa bookmark tab natin. Okay, so when you click on that, it will show you all the websites that you bookmark all together under or inside this folder, okay, or this bookmark folder, okay. So again, magandang ano to, ano, for those that are researching, para hindi niyo po nakakalimutan o hindi niyo nawawala ano, kung saan nanggagaling yung mga information nyo. Kasi napaka-common yan lalo sa mga estudyante natin. So you might want to also teach your students to bookmark their tabs so that they don't forget where they get their information. Okay, so next natin is privacy incognito. Okay, so part ng attempt ni Google Chrome to protect people from data breach, okay, or unnecessary access to their information, okay? They developed the privacy window incognito or the incognito window so that you can browse content in the web without leaving too much traces. Kasi the fact, teachers, that the moment you go online, you're actually exposing your data, no? Your location, possibly your names, your other important details, etc. Okay, even passwords, for example. Okay, but for when you're using incognito, no, it protects you from all of that. Okay, so how do we access incognito? Okay, when you go to a file, okay, you'll be able to open the incognito window. Okay? So you simply click on that. Okay. Okay, so now, teachers, no, take note. Ito yung mga reminders ni incognito window. Okay, so Chrome won't save the following information: okay, your browsing history, your cookies and site data, information entered in the forms. Okay, your activity might still be visible to your website you visit, your employer or school, your internet service provider. Okay, so hindi naman siya complete no trace browsing. No? There, you will still leave some traces, pero ang maganda kay incognito window, it minimizes the amount of information you leave behind when you are browsing the internet, okay? And that should be able to minimize then yung data breach and could protect your information online, okay? Lalo na po sa mga students at teachers, no? You might want to teach them to do this. Na pag nag-browse sila, for example, online, they might want to use the incognito window in order to prevent data breach. Okay, so that's how we access the incognito window. Okay, so next, teachers, is the Omnibox. So yung Omnibox, teachers, basically is your search bar. Okay, so where you put your URL sa taas, okay? That's your Omnibox. So where you put yours. Pero, teachers, no, si Omnibox natin, it does not only function for URLs, no? So pwede ka rin maglagay dyan ng searches, okay? So you can actually directly use it for as your search bar, okay? So when you type, for example, let's search, for example, kaagapay teacher support, okay, that also acts as a search bar, no? So aside from putting, for example, your websites, okay, or URLs here, you can also use this to search, no, as a search engine, right? That also works as a search engine. So yun na po, nakita niyo, teachers, no, lumalabas na dyan ngayon lahat ng mga related, no, contents, okay, websites about Kaagapay teacher support. Okay, so that's your Omnibox, teachers. Okay, so next natin is the Chrome Web Store. Yes, medyo favorite ko po ito ng Chrome Web Store. Kasi Chrome Web Store, teachers, ay sources ng inyong, what you call it? Sources ng extension and also your themes, no? And even applications, okay? So kapag may mga kailangan tayo, for example, sa extensions, dun po tayo pumupunta kay Chrome Web Store. Okay? So, hanapin natin si Chrome Web Store. Hindi pa siya naka-store dito. So we can simply go to Chrome Web Store. Okay. So this is how it looks like, teachers, no? Si Chrome Web Store. Okay, it allows you to download, okay, different extensions, okay, different themes, okay, for your Chrome, okay? So si extensions of the teachers, no, you can search here sa taas, okay? So you can easily you can put tags, okay, keywords, okay, to search for whatever extension you're looking for, okay? Or kung ayaw naman teachers maglagay ng tag, meron din po kayo dito. Or when you're searching teachers, no, you can also use here the different filters na pwede natin gamitin para mag-limit yung search results natin. So for example, kapag naghahanap ka ng extension, pwede kang mag-limit to, for example, gusto ko lang mga extensions na by Google. Okay, so pwede mong iset na only the things that will appear in the search results are only are only those that were developed by Google. Okay, so na for example, no, lahat ito, okay, ngayon na nakita niyo teachers, lahat yan yung mga extensions na developed by Google, okay, related to Google, okay. Or you can also limit filter your search results in Chrome Web Store using the different features. No? So for example, gusto mo na extension that runs offline. Okay. So it will, oh yeah. So ito na teachers, ibig sabihin, ang mga extensions that runs offline. Okay. The rest of the extensions, kailangan mo ng internet connection to run them. Okay. Example, mga extensions na free. Okay. Tanggalin natin yung runs offline. Doon naman tayo sa mga free. So ito naman yung mga extensions na free sa inyo. Okay. Or available at Android, okay? Anong mga extensions yung available for Android, for example? Tanggalin natin yan. Okay. So, ito yung mga extensions na available for Android, no? Okay? All the teachers na technically sa Android natin, so mobile devices natin, sometimes, itong mga app, extensions ito actually works as applications, okay? So, by definition, teachers, no, si extension is a way to interact with web page applications. Okay, so yun yung para siyang shortcut, right? So but basically these are mostly, okay, third party or applications na dinevelop na for Google, okay? Kasi yun nga yung sinasabi ko sa inyo teachers last time, no. Si Google does not want to put everything in its tools, okay? Kung sa totoo lang teachers, no, with the resources of Google, okay, he could easily integrate all the many features ng tools nila, no, so kung lahat ng mga development for Google Meet, for example, for Google Slides. Kaya lang hindi kasi yun yung idea ni Google, no. He would always opt for what they call a modular type of applications, okay, wherein users could further customize their experience, okay, and this is done through the extensions, okay, so access to web page applications, okay. And you can also limit, for example, or filter extensions based on if they work for Google Drive, okay? So ito naman yung mga, so wala po tayo ngayon so far, no, walang results on works with Google Drive, no, by Google. Tanggalin natin to, light natin all. Okay. Yan, so ito na ngayon yung mga extensions that work with Google or Google Drive. Okay, so pwedeng gamitin for Google Drive. Okay? So, yan. Okay? Dito rin teachers, na sa taas, you can also search by ratings. So, for example, gusto mo lang makakita ng mga 5-star ratings. Okay? Pwede mo yung ilagay dito. Okay? And then, dito sa taas teachers, no, sa baba ng extension, meron ka tinatawag na themes. No? So, pwede rin po kayong Miss Marion, it depends, no? Kung ano pong extension or anong function po yung gusto niyong gamitin, okay? For example, ako, yung mga common extensions ko, no, sa baka naglalagay ng mga extension. Mga usually add-ons pa nga yung ginagamit ko, not extensions, eh. So meron ako, for example, mga add-ons like Autocrat, okay? Pero add-on yung teachers, no? Kasi hindi ako masyadong fan ng mga extensions, no? Kasi ito yung disadvantage teachers ng extension, you also have to take note of it, okay? Dahil third-party app siya, sometimes they also have bugs or mga glitch, no? So, minsan bumabagal yung yung connection or yung paggamit ng application. I experienced that, no? When I was using Google Meet before at the start of the year, nung bagong free pa lang si Google Meet, and I remember I downloaded several extensions, okay? At sobrang bumagal po yung aking experience, no? Yan, si Kami. Yan, maganda rin yan. Si Kami for Peer. Kaya lang, Miss Jade, if I'm not mistaken, may bayad na po yata ngayon si si Kami. Limited lang yung trial, ano niya, time niya. Pero madami pong natutuwa dyan kay Kami. Okay? Kasi you can annotate PDF, no? As if you're writing on it. So, PDF annotator si Kami. Okay? So, teachers, please welcome kayo, no? Suggest po mga extensions that you're using that our classmates might find helpful, no? Sa Google Meet, may mga several extensions ka na pwedeng explore. For example, nga, Meet Attendance, extension. You can also explore the extension ito. Nakalimutan ko. I forget the extension. Pero madami mga extensions sa, ano, sa Google Meet. Pero nga, hindi, yun, Mute All to Meet. Okay? Screencastify. Although si Miss Pau na si Screencastify ay limited to 5 minutes lang yung ano no, yung recording, okay? Yeah, thank you so much for your mga recommendations. Yo, syempre yung si Google Docs offline, no? Kailangan niyo yan for offline mode ng inyong ano, si Bitmoji, okay? Sir Alex, sir, kung pwede mag-install ng extension ng teacher, need din mag-install ng students ng kanilang browser and same. It depends po sa extension yung teachers, no? May mga extension, for example, yung pinakita ko sa inyo last time, no, yung Mute extension, it does not require the student to for them to view it. So, hindi po nila yan usually kailangan i-download, okay? Hindi yan end-to-end installation. Okay. Yeah, so, ang dami ng features, mga extensions, okay? na pwede nyo matry, no? So, do try it. But ako personally, kasi hindi ako masyadong nag- very selective ako pagdating sa extensions. So, yun nga yung mga konting mga ginagamit ko yun. Mute extension, yun ang usual ko. Google Docs offline extension. Okay. Okay. So, aside from extensions, teachers, no, you can also explore no, yung themes. No? So, pwede nyo pong baguhin yung mga themes ng inyong what do you call this? Yung inyong browser. Okay. Para, for example, no, if you have multiple browsers open, multiple profiles, no, you can actually distinguish each one of them. Okay, mamaya papakita ko rin po teacher sa inyo, no, yung pag-set ng Chrome profiles. Okay? So, for example, palitan natin itong, ano ko, let's select this one. Okay. Oceanic. So, add to Chrome. Okay? So once you are, and teachers, no, either you're accessing extension or what do you call this? Themes, no, you only need to add it to Chrome. So for example, let's add it to Chrome. Okay? At magbabago na ngayon yung aking theme ng aking profile or ng aking browser. So yan. Parang mas maganda siya, no? I'll keep that. Okay. So extend natin. Okay? And then balik tayo, teachers, no? Mag-open tayo, for example, ng isang extension. Okay? Kasi kailangan nyo ding may malaman, no? So, when you open, for example, ito yung sinasabi ni Sir kanina, yung Screencastify, that allows you to screen record your screen. So, mga gumagawa po ng mga video lessons, okay? Very helpful po, no, si Screencastify. Okay? Kaya lang, based on experience, only limits you to 5 minutes, no, of recording, okay? Now, teachers, when you want to add an extension, okay, so lalabas po yan, for example.
Kami.
And then, lalabas din yung button na add to Chrome. Okay? And take note, teachers, no, you're not adding this to your device. Okay? You're adding this to your Chrome. Okay? So, pag lumipat po kayo ng ibang Chrome profiles, wala po dun yung extension na yun.
Okay?
So, usually, teachers, kapag nag-a-add po kayo ng extension, it will ask permission. Okay? Several access to your... your access to your Google Drive, for example, to your Google Documents, Google Slides, or Gmail sometimes, no? So, all the access that the extension needs to have, okay, you will have to grant it to them, okay, for you to be able to maximize the use of that, okay? Now, once you have downloaded, no, or added a an extension teachers, it now appears on top of your tab, no, or your Chrome, dun sa upper right corner. So may makikita ka dong puzzle like icon. Okay, pag click mo yung teachers, makikita mo lahat ng extensions that you have in your browser. Okay, so for example, right now meron akong Kami save to Google Drive. Okay, meron akong Screencastify. Okay, and mode or voice notes and feedback. Okay, so yun yung mga extensions ko, no? You can also pin that, teachers. For example, when you say you pin, lalabas po siya dun sa tab, no? Okay, for example, we pin the Screencastify, makikita niyo na po ngayon dun yung icon niya. Okay, so sa taas. Okay, so you can easily access it. Okay, and again, when you want to manage your extensions, meron po kayong ellipsis per extension. So you can remove the from Chrome, you can unpin it. Okay, you can also manage extensions. Okay, if you'd like to manage extensions, it would allow you to check, no, yung mga extensions na meron po kayo, ano yung mga gusto niyo tanggalin. Okay, so yun, for example, no, ito yung Kami for Google Chrome. Okay, so you can customize, no, how it works in your browser. Okay, so right now, for example, teachers, pwede mo rin i-visit, no, ito ngayon yung lahat ng extensions na meron ka. Okay, and take note, teachers, yes po, si Google Docs, Google Sheets, and Google Slides ay considered na extensions. Okay, that's the reason why, teachers, hindi kayo pwede mag-add ng extension sa inyo sa mga apps na to. Okay, ang what you can add here are what they call add-ons. Okay, kasi sila ay extension na. Okay, so you can manage, no, teachers, your other tools dito po sa loob ng ano yung management, managing your extensions. Okay, so labas lang tayo dyan. Okay, exit lang natin. Okay, so that's how you teachers, no, access your extensions. Now, how do I share extensions? For example, nakakita ako ng magandang extension and I want my students to also download it and install it into their Chromes para meron din silang access dito sa extension na to. Teachers, it's as easy as copying the URL on top. So pag na binuksan niyo po yung isang extension, dun po sa Omnibox, no, you can copy the URL. So copy natin yung URL. And you can send that anywhere, emails, messenger, kung saan man po. And when the student clicks on that link, for example, I just sent it in our chat box right now, okay? Pwede niyo na pong ma-download yan. Or it will now go to that extension, which will prompt you, or you will be able to download it already. Okay? Okay, so that's the Chrome Web Store, okay? Nung una ko, nung teachers, nung first ko ma-explore na, na-addict ako sa paggawa, sa pagkuha ng mga themes. Sobrang daming mga themes yan. Okay? So teachers, nun, napag-usapan natin kanina yung extensions, all about extensions. Okay? Again, si extensions ay isang klase ng way na to interact with the web page applications. Okay? So you can share it using a link. Okay? Meron pong mga Miss Jade, no, merong mga extensions, katulad po kanina, no, may pinakita ako kanina, merong mga extensions that work in Android or in mga mobile devices, pero hindi po lahat, okay? Well, definitely, sa Apple, hindi siya nag-work, no, okay? So, wala kang mga extensions na mag-work sa, ano, sa iOS, okay? Pero for Android, it merong mga konti lang, no, katulad, for example, Google Translate, Miss Jade, works in mobile phones, no? But you download it as an app actually. Okay? So they download mo siya as an app. Okay? So it's limited po kasi primarily teachers, no, as I mentioned, extensions are ways not to interact with web page applications. Okay? Kaya usually mga pang desktop and laptop lang po siya. Okay? I hope, Miss Jade, I was able to answer your question. Okay. Meron po, pero konti lang. Very limited. Okay. Okay, next po, Google Search. No? So, let's now look at Google Search. Okay. So, tapos na tayo, teachers, no, sa kay Google Chrome. Okay. Unless meron pa tayong mga iba pang mga pwedeng explore, may mga new things. Okay? Wala naman ang software teachers, no? Yan, for example, pwede ka na mag-add ng shortcut. Dati hindi ka pwede mag-add na. By default yan, on your most frequently visited and used applications. Okay, so next natin teachers, yung tinatawag natin Google Search. Now, of course, yan ang core ni Google, no? Diyan nagsimula si Google as a search engine. Okay? At diyan siya talaga kilala. Okay, so pagiging isang search engine. Okay? Ngayon, let's prior to some areas, no? So how do we search, no? In Google, okay? So the reminder ni Google when you're searching is to use keywords, okay? So hindi nagkakaroon ng problema in terms of search results, okay? Kapag meron po kayong mga unnecessary keywords or tags na ginagamit. Okay, so usually mas specific yung mga keywords nyo, much better. So yung for example, pagka-type ng mga sentences, hindi sobrang recommended, no? Because it actually produces more results that might not be necessary into your result unless you're actually asking that question, okay? That's the time you use a question, okay? So usually, for example, when we're searching, we use keywords. Now, for example, let's search for planets. Okay. Now, by algorithm features, no, syempre. At may konting kinalaman din syempre yung advertisement, no. So you can actually pay so that pwedeng mag-appear on top yung inyong content online, okay? So so yun na, nakapag-search na tayo, for example, planets yung ating keyword, no? Okay? So in this case, teachers, lalabas na ngayon dyan yung lahat ng search results, no? So nakalagay dun all, so lahat ng mga possible contents like web pages, images, etc. Okay? But take note, teachers, no, that you can also manage the search results, okay? By looking at the categories, no? So pwede mo, for example, gusto ko makita images lang. Okay? So I can choose that, okay? For example, gusto ko makita videos lang, okay, or maps, etc. So you can further filter the result using categories, no, of the search results. Okay. Now, aside from that, teachers, no, aside from using this, no, yung filters natin, yung mga categories to filter or to limit or to focus yung search results, no, okay, meron ka rin mga tinatawag na search tools. Okay. So ano man yung mga search tools, teachers, no? Meron ka dito sa taas, okay? Makita natin, okay? Tools, okay? Sorry. Okay. So when you click on that, teachers, no, yung tools natin, okay? It will now give you option, okay, to further filter your results, okay? So for example, dahil nasa videos tayo ngayon, na category ng videos, okay? So ito ngayon ang kanyang filters na pwede gamitin, okay? And when you use these filters, it will allow you to further limit the number of results, okay? So for example, ang gusto ko lang makita ng videos are videos that are 0 to 4 minutes, okay? So mga short videos lang. Okay? So malilimit na ngayon yan, no? So you will no longer see the other videos, no? Let's use another filter. For example, gusto ko ng mga videos that were uploaded into the internet just past 24 hours. So mas lumit na ulit, teachers, no? Mas kumunti na ulit yung videos natin. For example, gusto ko ng high quality videos, okay? Yung mga HD videos. So yun na po yung mga high quality videos natin, okay? For example, gusto ko na ang makita lang ay mga closed caption, no? Yung mga closed caption yan, yung may mga subtitles, okay? Or dito, you can also limit the videos, the source of the videos. For example, gusto ko lang ng videos that are coming from YouTube. Okay. So ngayon, teachers, I use several filters. No, nakita niyo, teachers, I use several filters here. Short video, past 24 hours, high quality from YouTube. Okay. So it now allows me to view the results much more efficiently. Okay, so mas konti yung lalabas at mas specific to your needs, no? So you can actually do that, okay? Once you're done at gusto mo na ulit bumalik sa search, you can simply clear that, okay? Now, teachers, no, your tools, your filters, also differ, no, across different categories. Okay, so for example, pag nilipat natin yung ating category to images, so gusto ko lang makita yung images, no, you can also check the tools at iba din yung ino-offer niyang filters, no, kasi images yan. Okay, so for images, ito yung mga filters mo. You can search by type. Okay, so either large, medium, or icon. So pag gusto natin medium lang na images. Color, nyari, for example, for this planet, I only want to see let's look for blue planets. So mga blue planets din papakita niya. Okay, type, for example, gusto ko ng clip art drawings. So ito yung mga clip art lang papakita niya. Okay, time, you can also add time, for example, as past month. Madami pa rin ba? Okay, so ito na ngayon yung mga images that was uploaded in the past month. Okay, here in images teachers, no, you can also set the usage rights, no, so yung tinatawag na Creative Commons licenses or commercial and other licenses, no? So you can already filter ang mga images, no, based on the usage rights, no? Kung ito po ay for copyrights or kailangan nyo bang mag-attribution, etc. Okay, so maiwasan na po natin yung mga copyrights infringement, no, sa paggamit ng mga materials, no. Although hindi naman ganun kahigpit ang copyrights pagdating sa education. Okay, kasi as long as you use it for education at non-profit yung purpose, hindi siya usually pinipursue, no, na copyrights infringement. Okay, and you can also clear that, teachers, if you're done, and you can set other other filters and modifiers to the results. Okay, now, so siyempre si results, teachers, kailangan din natin siyang alamin. Kailangan natin siyang pag-isipan, or we also have to be critical about the results. So not, that's one of the things that we have to teach our students. So not all the results in the web or in Google search are reliable. Okay? So for example, data coming from unreliable sources are supposed to be critically processed. Okay? Merong isang process na tinatawag na, yung tinatawag nilang triangulation or the three-way test, okay? Wherein, ang ginagawa mo, teachers, no, kapag nakakita ka ng information from a website, okay, you're going to verify it with another two sources, okay? Para you're actually triangulating if the information is correct, okay? Kaya nga po sinasabi niya, teachers, no, I always contest because they would usually say, oh, huwag ka gumamit ng Wikipedia, sobrang ano yan, unreliable. Totoo naman, sa ibang aspeto ng Wikipedia, unreliable siya kasi it's open for editing ng kahit sino. Okay? I remember this guy who's been the major contributor in Wikipedia, who has edited around 10 million pages yata ng Wikipedia yung na-edit na niya at nag-contribute siya dun sa mga contents nun. Okay? Pero, teachers, for example, if you're using Wikipedia, there's actually nothing wrong about it. Okay? If I may say, teachers, no, marami po gumagamit ng Wikipedia, even in the academy. No? Ang difference lang, nung smart na gumagamit ng Wikipedia, dun sa reckless or irresponsible use of Wikipedia, okay? Is that number one, ginagamit nila sa Wikipedia as a source, no? That's their initial source. Yun na yung source nila, okay? If you do that, then you are using Wikipedia the wrong way, okay? Ang use talaga ni Wikipedia, no, lalo na for example sa akin personally sa academe, ay it gives you that initial idea about your concept. Okay, so it will give you primary data or initial data about what you're searching. Okay, and then what you do after that is that once you've read, no, or once you've got an idea about your concept or your research, okay, then you look for other sources. Okay, you look to triangulate the sources or the information in Wikipedia. Okay, to validate the accuracy ng information from Wikipedia. Okay, so okay lang pong gamitin. Huwag lang gamitin si Wikipedia alone. Okay, so yan po yung malaking mistake natin sa paggamit kay Wikipedia. Okay? Sir, paano po kayo nag-search ng mga clip arts na ginamit niyo sa mga PowerPoint ng Kaagapay? Teach, pag po sa Kaagapay, naghahanap ako ng mga images. Pumunta lang ako sa mga free resources. For example, sa images, I use Unsplash. Okay? So, meron po mga resources no, ng images. Meron pang isa, yung tinatawag nilang get the website each. Sir Jophiel, I will try to search for it and I will forward it in our class. No? May mga iba pang mga websites where you can search for free clip arts. Okay? Pero ako, pinaka mostly kinakunan ko Unsplash. Okay? Kasi yun yung usually ginagamit kong background sa mga images no for Kaagapay. Or pag po, ayun, Pixabay. No? Ayan, Pixabay, maganda po yan. Okay? Or Sir Jophiel, usually, ang ginagawa ko lang, kaya para mag-search ng mga icons, okay? Naglalagay lang ako, ang keyword ko doon lagi, for example, ay flat icon. Pag gusto niyo pong gumawa ng mga ano, ng mga clip arts, okay? Yan po kasi yung mga, pag mag-search ka ng mga flat icon, okay? Yan po yung tsura niyang teachers, no? Yan. So, for example, naghahanap ka ng flat icon for an activity, a person, etc. Okay? Or yan yung ginagamit ko teachers na usually for imagery. So yung ginagamit ko lang na flat icon. Okay, for example, okay. So yan po teachers, no? Yan. Okay, na pwede po natin gamitin. Okay? Pero yun po tama, maganda po yung suggestion, Sir Christopher, no? Pixabay. Okay. Oh, ito. Okay. Thank you. Okay. My wife just sent me something that you can, I'll share it to you teachers no, in a while. Okay. Websites where you can get free images. Okay. Hanapin ko lang. Andali lang. Okay. So moving on teachers now while I'm looking for that. Okay. Okay, so next ang teachers, yung tinatawag natin na Google Help, no? Okay? So si Google Help naman teachers, no? Ay isang platform na ginawa ni Google in order for us to know where to get help, okay? So part din ng pagiging GCE niyo teachers, no? Yung idea na kapag naging GCE po kayo, hindi ibig sabihin noon, kailangan niyo nang masagot lahat ng tanong ng mga teachers, okay? In most cases, teachers, like for example, kahit ako po, kahit po ako isang Google Certified Trainer na, hindi ko rin po alam lahat. No? Hindi ko rin alam lahat ng mga nuances lahat, ng specifics ng lahat ng related to Google. Okay? Pero ang importante, teachers, sa ating mga Google Certified Educators, okay? At later on nun, pag naging Google Certified Trainers po kayo, importante po na alam nyo kung saan kayo hihingi ng tulong. Okay? Kung saan nyo po i-direct ang isang tao, regarding to what kind of help he needs, no? Okay? At si Google Help po ang sa mga makakatulong dyan, okay? So basically, si Google Help teachers, lahat ng mga technical questions nyo, mahanap nyo kay Google, or kay Google Help. So basically, that's your support.google.com. So if you need help, you go to support.google.com and it will send you to Google Help, okay? So pag meron po kayong mga katanungan, etc. no, mga kailangang tanong no, technical, okay, so the tools ni Google, okay, it will the first venue no kung saan po kayo kukuha ng sagot ay sa Google Help, okay, or sa support.google.com. Let me just fetch the link teachers para po dun sa nagtanong ng where can we get clip arts no or images, okay, just for example, well po no. Okay, so teachers, ano na, no? Si Google Help. Okay, so nandiyan na po lahat ng tools ni Google Help na kailangan nyo. So, for example, pag may tanong kayo kay Google Chrome, kay Google Search, kay Gmail, kay YouTube, so lahat, nandiyan na po lahat ng mga tools ni Google, no? Even mga other tools po ni Google, no? Makita nyo rin po dyan, okay? So lahat ng mga technical questions, they have a very wide array of articles, okay? That may help you. Okay, so for example, you open, may question ka about Google Chrome. Okay, yan. Okay? So example, may question kayo kay Google Chrome. So yan yung mga usually mga popular articles. Okay? Ngayon, nagkakaproblema ka about changing your Gmail settings. Okay? So pwede mo i-click yung article na yun. Okay? And it will show you this, teachers. No? At teachers, napakahalaga nito sa inyong GCE. Kasi pagdating nyo sa GCE nyo, teachers, you can actually open your Google Help. No? So you can have this open in your another device maybe. Or kung pwede kayo mag-split screen, so pwede habang nag-exam kayo, naka-open yung inyong Google Help kung may mga kailangan kayo or hindi kayo matandaan na concept or ideas no sa inyong sa exam, pwede nyo po siyang i-search. No? So, isa yun sa mga ways to help you during your examination para din mabawasan yung inyong anxiety. Okay? So, that's so again, tandaan teachers, no? Technical questions, technical aspect about Google Tools, Google Help tayo. Okay? Or, teachers, pati si Google Search, no? So, pag nag, ano ka, pumunta ka kay Google Chrome sa Google Search, pwede ka rin mag-type ng question dito. Okay? So, for example, yung isang question last time, no? How to archive a message in email. Okay? Teachers, very specific yung tanong ko, no? Hindi ako nag-keywords kasi specific na tanong talaga to. Okay? Baka sabihin niyo po kanina, ah, bakit kanina, ano? Okay? So, ito teachers, makita niyo meron ng article from support.google.com. You can click on that. Okay? And it will lead you to the answer. Okay, so kung paano ka mag-archive ng email sa Gmail mo. Okay, so yan na yung answer from Google Help Center. Okay? So again, teachers, no? Tandaan natin kasi again, pwede nyo itong magamit sa inyong Google Certified Educators examination. Hindi nag-a-appear yung ano. Sir po, sir, sino yung tanong kanina ng clip arts? Mamaya ko po isend yung link, no? Hindi nag-o-open din kasi medyo mabagal yung aking internet. Okay? Okay, so, yes. Smart man po, meron kayong natulong. Pero syempre, teachers, hindi po dapat na nakarely lang over sa ano, no, Google Help. Kasi, kung, if you recall your pretest, okay, yung mga questions po, hindi po lahat recall. Okay? Hindi nyo basta-basta pwedeng i-Google. Okay? Madami sa mga questions are need talaga no, to process, mga situational. Okay? Yes, pwede po. Okay? Yes, mga situational po. Okay? Kasi nga, ang goal talaga ni Google talaga sa ano is that hindi naman, it's also about learning. Kaya sabi ko sa inyo teachers, no, kahit the examination itself is a learning process. Kaya hindi po kayo pipigilan ni Google kung mag-search kayo ng mga concepts, ideas, okay? Sa Google search no, while you're taking your exam. Okay, okay, so that's one. No? So, si Google Help, that's one. And si Google search no, are ways no, to ask or to look for help in understanding or using Google for Education tools. Okay? So, ito na teacher kanina, napuntahan natin ito kanina, si Google Help Center. So, again, you have two areas no, or two places to look for answers on how to use Google for Education tools. Meron pa pong isa teachers. No? So, tatlo po yan. Okay, tatlo yung areas or na pwede nyo pagkunan ng answers. No? So, meron kang tinatawag din na Education Help Forums. Okay? Ngayon, ano naman ang difference sa teachers? No? So, pag pumunta tayo dyan, teachers, okay, search natin. Help Forums. Okay, so ang difference naman nito teachers, no, kapag meron po kayong mga questions that are practical in nature, no, mga for example, how to use Google Slides in, how to use Google Slides, okay, in giving assessments, okay, so something like that, okay, so you can actually use Education Help Forums in order for you to get answer. This is not anymore from Google, okay? Ang sasagot po sa inyo sa Education Help Forums ay mga Google users din. Okay, so pag-iisan na may mga tatanong tayo, mga forums yung pinupuntahan natin. So yan naman yung mga not so technical questions mo, no? But rather practical questions on the application of Google for Education tools, okay? So again, teachers, tatlo yung sources natin ng help for Google for Education tools. Google Help Center, Google Search, at saka yung tinatawag nating Education Health Forums. Okay, so pwede rin po natin yan makita. Okay? Or pagkuna ng answer. So pag hindi natin masagot ang answer ni teacher, pwede po tayong tumingin dyan or pwede natin i-direct no, si teacher to that. Okay? Okay, ngayon, teachers, nandito na ako ngayon sa ating next area. No? So yung aside from this websites or yung tatlong nabanggit ko, marami pa tayong pwedeng pagkuna ng help about Google for Education tools. Okay? Another form of help no, na in-offer ni Google ay yung tinatawag na Google Educators Groups. Okay? So, si Google Educators Group ay sort of like a community, of course. It's a community in order to support Google Education tools users. Okay? So, ang ginagawa natin ng teachers, nagbibuild ng communities no, of Google users for them to share their experiences, expertise, at saka siguro questions also and problems no, about using Google for Education tools. Okay? So let's go to that. Okay? Okay? Nandito na pala ako dito. Okay. Okay. Simple. Okay, so teachers, no? When you hindi na pala ako lumabas, no? So teachers, no, kapag gusto niyo makita, makikita dito niyo ma-search no sa edu.google.com, makikita niyo yung mga communities near you. Okay? So far, ganito na po kadami ang mga Google educators sa buong mundo. Okay, so the bigger the circle, the more GEGs, no? Yun po yung shortcut, teachers, no? GEG yung shortcut, okay? So iba po yan sa GCE, iba rin po yan sa GCT, no? So be careful on using those acronyms, no? So for example, right now, ito yung mga biggest areas natin sa, okay, sa mundo, no? Okay, somewhere in South America, okay? Sa Pilipinas, teachers, okay, ilan meron ba tayo? Hindi lang siya naglo-load ngayon. Okay, but let's search that. Okay. Ngayon, teachers, no, si GEG are not directly actually supervised by Google. Okay, so mga independent groups po talaga yan. Okay? Na minamanage ng mga Google Certified Educators tsaka Google Certified Trainers or sometimes even Google Certified innovators, no? So let's, for example, search for communities, no? Okay, so right now, yan. Ito yung map natin. Okay. Kung nasa na po tayo ngayon. Yan. So for example, right now, we have 12 in the Philippines. Okay, so 12 po tayo ngayon sa Pilipinas. Okay, ang pinakamadami po teachers ay nandyan sa South America, okay, 151 GEGs, no? So, napakadami teachers, okay? So dito teachers, example, click natin yung sa Pilipinas, kung ano po yung mga GEGs sa Pilipinas. Yes po, kailangan nyo pong, meron pa tayong mga ano, marami, kukonti pa lang po ang GEG, at madami sa GEGs po natin, hindi pa sobrang active din po, no? So we're actually trying to revive it. So far po teachers, ito po ang inyong mga GEGs ngayon. So GEG Butuan, GEG Caloocan, GEG Iligan, La Union, Makati, Mandaluyong, North Cotabato, Ortigas, yung pong overall natin, Philippines, Quezon City, San Juan. Teachers, ako po yung leader ng GEG San Juan. Okay? And of course, GEG South Manila. Okay, so yan po ang ating mga iba't ibang GEG. And yeah, kaya nga teachers, Trace, mga sasabi ko sa inyo, no? After po ninyo mag-take ng GCE nyo, sana po isa sa mga maging goal nyo or vision nyo is makapag-put up po kayo ng GEG sa mga places nyo. Kasi marami pa po talagang places na walang mga GEG. Okay? Ms. Laverne, ano pong sin-search natin? Yan, wala pa po. Yes, wala pa. So, Ms. Marisa, tayo na po tayo ng GEG natin sa Iloilo. So, GEG Iloilo. Okay. Ngayon, teachers, ano, ano mga requirements ito? Kailangan ba lahat GCEs na agad? Hindi po. Okay? Precisely what you're going to do is to pull together people who might become GCEs in a, later on, or kung hindi man sila maging GCEs, naging ano sila, no, heavy users, or you can provide the community where you can give help in using Google for Education tools. Okay? Okay. Ano lang to teach? Punta ka lang sa edu.google.com. Okay? Okay, so wala pa po yan. So, Sir Jaben, ikaw na po ang magtatayo ng GEG Katbalogan or GEG Samar. Okay? Yes, wala pa rin po. So, teachers, challenge po sa ating lahat yun. Talunin natin ang ito, itong 151 na to. At lampasan natin yung kanilang dami ng kanilang GEGs. No? Teachers, anong benefit nito? The more GEGs we put up in the country, the more communities of help or the more support will teachers will have, no, in our communities. Kasi isa sa mga challenge, no, bakit ang mga teachers are sometimes not using Google for Education tools, eh kasi ako konti yung support or sometimes hindi sila natuturuan. Okay, but if we have GEGs, no, that will put up programs, trainings, okay, and help or become a venue for people to ask questions, this could actually become a venue, no, to help others, no, and gain confidence in using Google for Education tools. Okay. Okay, so next natin is yung tinatawag na Professional Learning Network. Teachers, wala naman itong ano, no, hindi ako makapagpakita ng Professional Learning Network, pero basically the idea of Professional Learning Network is you're creating different sources of information, okay? So it's like you're building a database of sources of information, no? Communities. So for example, meron kang websites, Facebook communities, mga Facebook pages, where you can source information, training programs, okay? Conversations, forums, etc. No? So all together, teachers, no, lahat ng ito, to mga collectively, tiyatawag silang professional learning network, okay? Kasi ginagamit mo siya to actually learn about a particular thing or teachers. So, recommended yung teachers na for mga schools, mga professionals, kayo po, for example, no, because professional learning networks allows you to access information or to share also information to others, okay? So, mahalaga rin po na maka-develop tayo yung tiyatawag na professional learning networks natin, okay? Kaagapay, teachers, kaya if you consider na pwede rin siya maging part ng tinatawag yung professional learning network, kasi you get information, you also get webinars, trainings, etc. from Kaagapay Teachers Support, okay? Okay. Okay. Okay lang, Miss Pao. Miss Pao, mag-view ka na rin ng sarili mo, ano, no? GEG. Hanggang ilang GEG po pwede salihan kasi po wala sa area ko. Miss, better talaga nun magtayo sa area nyo, okay, ng GEG. No? Wala namang limit yan, no? Kahit saan kang maging part ng GEG. Kasi, again, Miss Pao, no, yung idea ng GEG is just community. Okay? So, you can belong to multiple communities at the same time. Okay? Pero it's still recommended that you when you that you put up a community or a GEG in your place para magkaroon ng community of Google users in your place para hindi na po sila lalayo at hindi na sila mangangapit bahay or mangangapit bayan, okay, para sa feeling GEG, okay? So teachers, no, by definition, professional learning networks are any groups that engages in collaborative learning with others outside of their community. So aside from sources of information, no, PLNs or a professional learning network could also be collaboration between different schools. No? So for example, you also collaborate with another school to develop programs, okay, or design curriculum. You are benchmarking with other country, with other schools. That's actually creating a professional learning network. Okay? So the moment that you create connections, no, with other schools, informations, groups, organizations, in order to learn, improve education, you're actually creating a professional learning network. Okay? Or in general, no, hindi lang education, but at work as well. Okay? So that's professional learning networking. Okay, so aside from the teachers, no, so aside from GEGs or Google Educators Group, pwede rin po kayong lumapit sa mga Google Certified Trainers, okay? Hindi ko lang masyadong, hindi pa masyadong ano, no, polish yung search button dito, pero dapat po, you can actually search dito sa edu.google.com okay, for trainers, no? Or other communities po. So, pwede kayo mag-search po dito ng mga trainers din. Okay? So, let's look for, hanap tayo. So, let's look for Google Certified Trainers. Okay, so teachers, may mga difference sa teachers, no? Kapag si Google Certified Trainers, okay, ang talagang primary goal nito or primary role niya bilang isang trainer, no, ay isa siyang mag-focus siya on training teachers to become Google Certified Educators. Okay? So, yung primary goal niya, okay? It could, in general also, it's a way to leverage, educators, no? Or help educators transform their classrooms using Google tools. No? So, in general, yun din yung goal niya, no? to allow teachers to use or optimize the use of Google tools for their school. So, yun yung primary, isa rin sa mga primary roles ni Google Trainer, okay? So yeah, so you can if you want to apply, so you can actually apply, no? So hindi naman siya ganoon kadali, no? Ah, kahirap. Meron lang yung mga series, pero ang requirement ni Google Certified Trainer, dapat po daipasan niyo ang Google Certified Educators Exam 1 and 2. So dapat level 2 na po kayo before you take this, okay? Now, when we want to find Google Certified Trainers, no? Pwede po tayo pumunta sa Edu Directory, okay, with Google. Okay. So, Edu Directory with Google allows you to search for trainers, no, within your vicinity. So, pwede po kayo mag-search dito ng mga tao, okay? So, services, etc. No? So, dito niyo po makikita yung mga possible persons or trainers within your area, okay? Pero again, no, personal ako, nahihirapan ako mag-search dito kasi meron siyang mga requirements na keywords, no? Okay? So, pwede po natin mag-experiment dito. Pero dapat po dito nyo makikita sa Edu Directory yung mga Google Trainers, Google Innovators, and Google Coaches natin. Okay? So, that's another way to ask for help. Okay? Aside from the teachers, meron po tayong tinatawag na Google Certified Innovators. Okay? So, ano naman si Google Certified Innovator Teachers? Si Google Certified Innovators, sila yung members ng community that create solutions, okay? So ito yung mga transformative innovator educators po natin. So gumagawa po sila ng mga projects in order to solve the problems of their communities, no? So si innovators compared to trainers, sila yung mas mga practical application ng Google for Education tools, okay? Si trainers, yun yung sila yung mga technical persons, no, for Google for Education tools, okay? So again, it depends on our needs kung sino lalapitan natin, kung Google Innovators ba or Google Trainers yung lalapitan natin, okay? Aside from the teachers, pwede rin tayong maghanap ng mga tinatawag nating certified coach muna. So before tayo pumunta sa reference schools, certified coach naman, sila naman yung nag-aalat na ng one-to-one correspondence in terms of trainings, okay? So compared to trainers and innovators, ang focus ni coach ay one-to-one in a long-term period, okay? That's why, for example, no, mas matagal ang applications ni certified coach kumpara kay innovator tsaka kay trainer. If you want to become certified coach, you'll have to work with a teacher for at least 2 months, no, or 3 months in guiding them, no? And si certified coach, hindi lang siya nakafocus just on the tools or Google for Education tools, no? Ang focus niya is in a more general sense ay yung tinatawag na technology and school transformation, okay? So yung paggamit ng technology at technology integration sa education, okay? So yung mas generalized. Kaya nga, dahil malawak yung scope ni coach, ni certified coach, nakafocus lang siya sa isang tao. So he will help that person to understand technology integration, use technology integration, and evaluate eventually the use of technology integration. Okay, so pag naghahanap po tayo ng one-on-one mentoring, Google Certified Coach po yung hinahanap natin. Okay? So they function differently, although hindi naman ganun ka-strict yan, no? Kasi definitely yung mga Google Certified Innovators natin, kaya din nila mag-coach, no? Although hindi lang sila certified. Okay, they can also train, etc. No? Okay, so they there's actually a very gray area or thin area between these different types of experts in Google for Education. And of course, we can also look for, balik tayo dun sa isa kanina, reference schools teachers. No? So si reference schools naman, teachers, yan yung tinatawag natin na mga model schools. No? So ito yung mga schools na gumagamit talaga ng Google for Education tools or nag very efficient, no, in technology integrations. Kaya ang tawag sa kanila yung reference schools kasi Google would usually recommend them for benchmarking or other things. No? So pwede sila yung maging model at gayahin ng ibang schools. So yan po yung tinatawag natin na reference schools. No? Okay. Meron ka rin tinatawag na mga Google for Education Partners. Okay? So say Google for Education Partners naman, teachers, mga ano yan, mga companies, corporations, okay? Mga groups, okay, that actually helps Google in implementing its programs, okay, or supporting its programs, okay? So mga multinational companies yan usually, okay, that supports Google in or Google for Education. Transformation schools, no? Dito transformation schools. These are transformation partners, okay? So, yung transformation partners teachers naman, okay? Yan naman yung mga individuals or groups, no? That helps in transforming a school into transitioning to Google for Education tools, okay? Teachers, no, good news then, okay? Let me also share with you. Will also be participating in this program, no? Google is offering us a partnership in terms of helping in transforming schools to becoming G Suite, Google for Education schools. Okay? Because by next year, Google will be rolling out around 22 million Google accounts for students. Okay? So many public schools, no, will be transforming or will be shifting to Google for Education tools. So ang gagawin po ni Google, they're now looking for groups, no, for example like Kagape Teacher Support, who will be training schools to transition to Google for Education tools. So pag pray niyo po kami kasi medyo mabigat pong trabaho to, no, medyo madami-daming schools ang pupuntahan na namin to be able to train teachers, no, or transition to Google for Education tools, okay? At sana po isa kayo sa mga schools na yan at mapuntahan namin kay teachers, no. But hopefully this is the time na wala ng pandemic, okay? As we roll out next year and next year, okay? Okay, so ito teachers, no, kanina pinakita ko na to. Ito yung Google for Education directory. You can only you can simply go to edu directory with google.com and you should be able to see itong mga teachers. You can search for the trainers, innovators, coaches, mga reference schools, etc. Okay, so you can they have a list of people, persons, okay, under these categories in edudirectory.google.com. okay, so sometimes this is over updated pero can still be used. Okay. Okay, so teachers, questions? Okay, I think that would be actually it, no? For today, okay? Na-cover na ba natin lahat? I think we have covered already everything, no? Okay, so teachers, if you have questions, sana po Miss Marisa, no? Kapunta kaming Iloilo. Last session tomorrow, teachers. But again, teachers, no, may expect natin the last session tomorrow to be longer. I'm looking at around 2.5 hours tomorrow. We'll begin promptly at we'll begin promptly at 7 p.m. tomorrow para po matapos natin lahat. Tomorrow will be a two-part session. We'll be finishing up all our contents tomorrow, so we'll be looking at Google Excel, Google Sheets, Google Slides, and YouTube as well. We'll be exploring YouTube tomorrow, and digital citizenship, okay? Then after that, teachers, after natin ma-cover lahat ng mga remaining tools natin, I'll be guiding you already for the registration. So sana po tomorrow, ready na tayo to actually register, no? Or mag-create ng account. Kasi ang gagawin natin bukas, we will create accounts live, no? Habang ginagawa ko po, at gagawin na rin po ninyo, okay? Para po nandun na kayo kagad or meron na kayong ma-set up na account for your Google Certified Educators Examination, okay? So that's going to be our goal for tomorrow. So dapat po tomorrow, naka-register na tayo. Not to the exam, but to the exam platform. Okay? Now, teachers, regarding buying of vouchers, payment, i-discuss ko rin po sa inyo yung bukas, no? Together with the registration orientation. Miss Babic, hindi pa po. Okay? You will only have to pay when you buy the exam. Okay, gagawin pa lang po natin ngayon. Gagawa tayo ng account kung saan kayo bibili ng exam ninyo. Okay? Isi-set up lang po natin yun para anytime that you decide to buy the exam, you can already pay and get the exam po. Okay? Pero mag-set up pa lang po tayo ngayon. Okay? I'll talk about all of those tomorrow. Tomorrow na rin po natin isama. No? Meron pa tayo na-miss na isang tool today. Google Earth. Okay? So bukas na rin po natin siya isingit. Okay? Since longer session naman tayo tomorrow. Okay? Miss Maris, yung pong actual Google Certified Educators exam, anytime po yun. Okay, kayo po ang bahala nun. Okay? Pero ako talaga, personally, I recommend that you take the exam midnight, yung sa gabi. Nung nag-exam po ako nun sa GCE, in both cases, level 1 and 2, I took it at 11 p.m. to 2 a.m. Bakit? Mabilis ang internet, walang masyadong distraction, tulog ng ibang tao, so you could actually focus. Sir Jaben, examination, you can actually have retakes, yung first retake nyo, you failed, okay? Yung first retake nyo could be taken after 14 days of the results, okay? The next one is after 3 months, okay? So yung second retake mo. If you failed again, the third retake will be after a year, okay? Teacher Jophiel, questions po would be around 31 items, composed of 20 multiple choice and 11 skill-based items. Yes po, Sir Christian Niebres, the exam will run for 180 minutes, 3 hours. Miss Mavic, every exam you'll have to pay. So wag po nating sayangin, no. Wag nating isipin na may retake naman, wala pong ganoon. Wag nating isipin na yung teachers, no. Mag-focus tayo that we will not have the retake, okay? Na pag lumaban tayo, diretso na kayang-kaya natin, okay? Touch mo po ang sagot, hindi po, Miss Maris, okay? Meron pong tinatawag na review, okay? So you can actually go back to the questions kung meron pa kayong oras. For example, natapos kayo sa exam, meron pa kayong oras, you can actually go back to all the questions and review them before submitting. Okay? In each question, Miss Maris, no, while you're taking the exam, dun sa each question, meron dong mark for review. So if you like, for example, meron kong item na nahirapan ka, you can actually mark it for review at sa dulo, makikita mo na kung ano yung mga items na minark mo for review. Although, technically, kahit hindi mo minark for review, pwede mong balikan lahat. Okay. May ilan po kaya ang nagbayad? Sir Jophiel, no, lahat po magbabayad kapag bibili ng exam. Sir, may validity po ba yung certificate? Yes po. 3 years po ang validity ng Google Certified Educators Examination. Sir Aaron Batak, no, totoo po, tama po. Nag-iiba iba ang exam. Okay? Kasi hindi kayo, for example, no, hindi kayo pwedeng magkabi, for example, magkaibigan kayo at mag-take kayo ng exam altogether, hindi po kayo magkapareho ng exam. Okay? Mamaya, nagtatawagan kayo, nagchat kayo, anong sagot sila? So, number one, ako, problema po yan. What happens, teacher, is that ang ginagawa ni Google, meron siyang pool of questions At per examinee, naka-randomize yung mga questions na yun doon sa ano, sa test niya. Result po ng vote poll for mock test. Right now po, ang ating result no ng ating mock test ay 7 PM to 10 PM ang ating exam time. No? So, i-reserve na po natin. Okay? I'll be putting up 2 examination dates for your mock exam teachers. I'll be giving it on Saturday and Sunday since yun po yung dalawang nanalong dates no dun sa first poll natin. So I might vary no since madami din ang pumili ng 2 to 5 p.m. Okay? I might make the Saturday 2 to 5 p.m. and the other exam date Sunday 7 p.m. to 10 p.m. Or baka magbaliktarin ko po no, kasi ayaw naman po nating malate tayo ng gising kinabukasan kasi Monday may pasok. Okay? Para lang po ma-cater and ma-address natin lahat ng mga pumili po nung Saturday and Sunday tsaka ng 2 PM to 5 PM tsaka 7 PM to 10 PM po. Okay? I'll be sending the dates or the details tomorrow teachers. Okay? And don't forget, isa lang po yung dates na pipiliin nyo dun na. Hindi nyo po kailangan mag-test on both dates. Okay? That's only a mock test. Okay? And for the mock test teachers, that will be the basis of your certificates. That will also run for exactly 3 hours. Okay? Passing grade po for the mock test is 50. Okay? So you'll have to get 50 out of 85. Okay? At least 50 out of 85 to be able to get the certificate. Sir Christian, when your certification expires, you will only have to take the recertification. Sa recertification po, Sir Christian, wala ng multiple choice. All skill-based questions na po. Miss Pao, pwede po, pero huwag niyo isipin yun. Okay, I'm confident na makakapasa ka po, Miss Pao. Sure na ako dyan. First take niyo lang, Miss Pao. I can feel it, Miss Pao. Baka nga hindi ka pa nagtitest, Miss Pao, pasado ka na. Yes. Sir, kapag bumagsak sa mock exam, wala pong certificate na matatanggap po. Yan po yung ating ano, Sir DJ. No? Kasi commitment dapat natin na mag-attend ng mga trainings, gawin yung mga tasks, at talagang matuto. Okay? Pero Sir DJ, no, based on experience, ang hirap namang hindi makapasa dun sa mock test. No? Lalo na we already went through everything that supposedly asked or contained or part no, ng mock test namin. Yes, sana all we can do. Yes. Miss Nage, don't worry. Okay? Maramdaman niyo po yan. Kaba lang yan, Miss. Usually po na nasusupersede na niya yun, Miss Pao. Okay? Kapag level 2 ka na, yung level 2 na ang basis mo. Okay? Doon ka na lang nag-re-certify. So nasusupersede na niya ngayon yung level mo. Okay? Yes, batch 5, pasado na. Okay, teachers. If you have questions, no, you can remain in the call. Okay, I can still entertain some questions no further. Okay? But for those that needs to go, no, I think I'll have to, I can already dismiss. But before we do that, let's take our usual class picture since naging habit na natin mag-take class picture. Kayo lang po ang class na meron akong pictures everyday. No? Napaka-special ng class na to. Okay? So, isa mga classes ko po before, batch 1 to batch 4, nag-take lang ako ng pictures sa start na session and then wala na. Or graduation pictures na. Ito lang ang class na may everyday picture. Okay? Yes, Miss Nage, feel nyo na po yan. Okay? Baka nga maipadala na kagad yung certificate sa inyo, Miss. At saka yung badge. Okay? Teachers, I'll be taking our picture now for a while. Okay, wait lang po. Let's open our cameras, teachers. Okay? Waiting for the names to hide. Okay. Okay, smile at teachers. I will count once the names are hidden na po. Okay. Sobrang sakit ko na mata ko ngayon. Okay, ready teachers? In 1, 2, 3. Okay, got it teachers. Now teachers, if you have no more questions, you may now go. Enjoy the rest of the evening. Have a nice rest and good luck for tomorrow. Last day for tomorrow and almost weekend. Okay? So, bye teachers and have a nice evening. Miss Maris, magkano delivery ng physical certificate po? Nako, hindi po nagdi-deliver ng physical certificate. Thank you po. Digital certificate lang po. Thank you po. Wala po bang sponsor, sir? Sir Nick, kapag naging partner na po kami ni Google, magbibigay na rin po kami ng free GCE vouchers. Asahan niyo po yan.
Talaga lang, sir. Sana ngayon, yes, sana susunod na, sir.
Abangan na lang muna po natin, Sir Nick, no? Kasi ngayon, syempre, wala pa pong budget ang Kaagapay Teacher Support. But we know that kung ano man po meron kami, Sir Nick, will always send it out to the teachers. Okay? Walang bayad-bayad. Okay?
God bless po sa inyo.
Welcome, Sir Nick, no? Always po. Okay? So, teachers, I'll see you tomorrow. Have a nice evening. Kung wala na po kayong questions, enjoy the evening, teachers. Okay? Alexa, play music, please.
Getting an American Top 40 station from iHeartRadio.
Dirt by the basics of the elevator. What look like a music video shoot? If so,
Alexa, play Tatak Pinoy.
Sorry, I'm not sure about that.
Stepped into the role of an oil worker.
Play Alexa, play acoustics.
Getting radio heartland station from iHeartRadio.
Alexa, anong sagot doon sa mock test?
Naka, hindi kasi nagot, sir. Hindi pa siya nakaintindi ng Tagalog, sir. Let's Alexa, what is Google Certified Educators?
Here's something I found on the web. According to CFS.net, Google certified teachers are exceptional educators with a passion for using innovative tools to improve teaching and learning, as well as creative leaders and ambassadors for change.
Oh, and the creative and experts in the field. Exceptional teachers. Teachers, I'll close and turn off the recording na po. I'll end the call na po.